Hello, Precious Friend. I'm Pastor Danny Davis. You know, for over 40 years, I've been traveling the world preaching the gospel, and I've seen tens, if not hundreds of thousands of people saved over a 40-year period in my life. And I've also been teaching and preaching on prosperity for the better part of my life. Now, I want to let you know something, because I'm kind of doing a part two to a teaching I recently did. You may have seen it. It's on what I call stinking thinking, divine prosperity that comes from the hand of God. I'm kind of doing part two to that, felt like I needed to. You need to understand something. In the United States of America, you've got like two major political parties. You've got the Democrats over here and Republicans over here, and they're almost divided right down the middle. About half of America's Republican, half of America's Democrat, for the most part. And it's the same way in the evangelical church world. You've got two different schools of thought. You have a group of people that absolutely think if you mention money in any way, shape, or form, you're worldly, you know, you're not of God, you're a false prophet. You know, I could go on and on and tell you what they'll say. Because I'm mentioning money in this teaching today, and I promise you the haters are going to come out, and they'll come out strong against me because I dared, as a preacher of the gospel, to talk about money. 50% of the church world, the evangelical church world, hates the message of prosperity. Now, the other 50% of the church world, they believe that God involves himself in our finances and prospers us and blesses us the same way he saves us. And the same way he heals us. 50% of the church world believe that God is a God of financial blessing. And I'm going to share a scripture with you quickly before I say anything else. There's a scripture in the Bible that says Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us, for it is written, cursed is he who hangeth on the tree. You have to track back and understand what the curse of the law was. The curse of the law was poverty, sickness, and death. Christ has redeemed us from poverty, sickness, and eternal death. Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us. Just as much as God wants to save your soul, he also wants to get involved in your health and in your finances. I believe that with all of my heart, but there's a lot of stinking thinking that goes on in the body of Christ. People that absolutely, if you mention money, they'll blow a gasket. They cannot stand for you to mention money. You're a crook if you mention money, especially if you're a preacher. Now, we've got a story here in the Bible. It's found in Mark chapter 10 of a rich young ruler. Mark chapter 10 and verse 17. This rich young ruler, a very righteous young man, came to Jesus. By today's standards, he was a multimillionaire. And he said, what must I do to inherit eternal life? And Jesus said, well, what's the scripture say? And he went right down the list of the Ten Commandments. The rich young ruler said, well, Lord, I've done all these things from my youth up. And the Bible says, because this young man lived such a righteous life, Jesus' heart was touched. And he looked at that young man. He said, I'll tell you what. He said, one thing you lack, go sell all that you have, give it to the poor, and then come follow after me, and I'll make you one of my disciples. Now, do you understand what an opportunity Jesus gave that young man? In other words, it's 2,000 years later. Today, we would know that young man's name. He would have gone down in history as one of the apostles. He would have been someone that the church world celebrated for over 2,000 years, but we don't know his name. We don't know anything about him other than what I'm telling you right now, because the Bible says when Jesus told him to give away his great wealth and come follow after him, be a disciple, the Bible says he went away very sorrowful, for he had great wealth. Well, Peter was watching this whole conversation go on. And further in the scripture, Peter came to Jesus. He said, but Lord, he said, we've forsaken all and followed you. And Jesus made a statement. I want to share it with you. It's found in Mark chapter 10 and verse 29. Jesus told the apostle Peter, who was very sorrowful. He said, well, we gave away everything and followed you. And Jesus said, Peter, verse 29, nobody's left brethren or houses or sisters or fathers or mothers or wives or children or lands or anything else for the gospel's sake, but he shall receive 100-fold now in this time. And then Jesus said, after you receive the 100-fold persecution, and after that eternal life. Now, I like to talk about the fact Jesus put a persecution clause in there. In other words, Jesus said, when your heart is after the gospel, whatever you forsake for the gospel's sake, it's coming back 100-fold in this present time. In the Greek, it actually says in this lifetime, but with persecution. Why do people persecute someone for being prospered for the gospel's sake? Well, I believe it's because once you start moving in the 100-fold, once you start being blessed, because God has decided to bless you, because your heart is right and you love the gospel, you're going to make jealous people even more jealous. You're going to make the haters come out. Prosperity comes with a price. Jesus said the price that it comes with is persecution. Persecution always follows the 100-fold return. However, the 100-fold return is promised. One of the things we are redeemed from when we're redeemed from the curse of the law is poverty. Did you know prosperity and material goods are mentioned over 800 times in the scripture? Throughout the Bible, we're given financial advice, and God is telling us over 800 times. That's the second most mentioned topic in the Bible is prosperity. But you have to understand, when you begin to talk about prosperity, people who have a religious spirit get angry. Well, I'm Pastor Danny Davis. I wanted to come back and talk to you once again about the 100-fold return and about stinking thinking in the body of Christ.